Hello viewers, welcome to Plant Science Channel. I am Likita Reddy here. In this video we will be learning about anatomy or the internal structure of pinus stem. The internal structure of pinus stem resembles with that of the dicot stem, which has got differentiated into epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, vascular tissue and then the pith. So first comes to the epidermis. Epidermis is irregular in outline and consists of single layer of cells which are got covered with the thick cuticle. And next comes to the cortex. Here the cortex has got differentiated into outer cortex and then the inner cortex. So here next to the epidermis you can see the cortex. So the outermost layer, few layers of the cortex are lignified which are of sclerenchymatous zone. And next comes to the inner cortex. So the inner layers consist of thin-walled parenchymatous cells with the presence of number of resin canals or as the resin ducts. So followed by the cortex, you can see the indistinguishable endodermis and pericycle. So here you can't distinguish the pericycle and then the endodermis. And next comes to the vascular tissue region. So here the vascular tissue region consists of 5 to 9 vascular bundles. Here we will be calling these are as the vascular bundles. 5 to 9 vascular bundles are arranged in the ring. So each vascular bundle is conjoint, collateral and open. Here the conjoint is nothing but xylem and phloem are arranged together in a same radius, while the collateral is nothing but the xylem is arranged towards the pith while the phloem is arranged away from the pith. And open condition is nothing but you can see the presence of cambium in between the xylem and phloem. And here the xylem is endarch in condition, that is nothing but protoxylem are present towards the pith and metaxylem are present away from the pith. Next comes to the elements of xylem and phloem. So the xylem has got divided into two types, protoxylem and metaxylem, as we know. So here the protoxylem consists of spiral and annular tracheids, while the metaxylem consists of reticulate thickenings, and the true xylem vessels are absent, remember. And then the phloem consists of sieve tubes, phloem parenchyma and albuminous cells, and these companion cells are absent. And the pith is made up of parenchymatous cells. So this is about the internal structure of pinus young stem. Now let us study about the pinus older stem and then the secondary growth. Moving on to the secondary growth, pinus stem increases its thickness by secondary growth. The formation of secondary xylem and secondary phloem takes place along with that medullary rays are abundantly present so that the wood is soft. So now let us study the stages which are occurring in the secondary growth of pinus stem. So first what happens, the stripe of cambium that is of interfascicular cambium. So this is of the interfascicular cambium. Interfascicular cambium is nothing but the cambium which is formed in between the vascular bundles. That will be formed in between the vascular bundles. And in second stage what happens, the interfascicular cambium join with the intravascular cambium. Remember, interfascicular cambium means the cambium stripe which is formed in between the vascular bundles, while the intravascular cambium is nothing but the stripe which is formed in between the xylem and phloem. So that is nothing but the xylem and phloem. So in the second stage what happens, so in the first stage what happens, the interfascicular cambium is formed. In the second stage, the interfascicular cambium joins with that of the intrafascicular cambium and forms a complete ring. So here you can see interfascicular cambium has joined the intrafascicular cambium and that has formed the complete ring. So this cambial ring cuts off the secondary xylem towards the inner side. So towards the inner side the secondary xylem will be present and the secondary phloem will be present outer side. So by the activity of vascular cambium, Secondary vascular tissues are added continuously, which in turn increases the girth of the stem. So that's why you can see there is an increase in the thickness. Here the primary phloem is crushed. So the primary phloem will be present in a crushed manner because of the pressure of secondary vascular tissue. The secondary xylem and secondary phloem form every year in the cambial ring. Remember, the secondary xylem and secondary phloem will be formed every year in the cambial ring. The xylem ring formed in a year is differentiated into springwood and then the autumn wood. Here the springwood and then the autumn wood. The dark colored portions, that is of autumn wood. So below that you can see the springwood. In the autumn season, where there is a leaf fall, no need of water and nutrient translocation. Hence the narrow tracheids are formed in this season. While in the spring, what happens, there will be a new leaves and new branches are formed. Thus, the translocation of water and nutrients are required. So, hence the broad tracheids are formed in the xylem. So, remember, the one annual ring consists of one springwood and one autumn wood. So, like that, the age of the plant can be calculated. Understood, right? So, how the autumn wood is formed means the xylem elements with a narrow tracheids forms the autumn wood, while the xylem elements with the broad tracheids will be forming the springwood. Why? Because in the autumn season there will be not much requirement is there for the translocation of this water and then the nutrients, while in the spring season, as the emergence of new leaves and new branches are taking place, they require more translocation of nutrients and water. So like that you can differentiate the autumn wood and springwood. So together the autumn wood and springwood will form a one annual ring. So now let us take up a slide study which is helpful for your lab. Here you can see a slide picture which is of Pinus 1 year old stem. So here at the middle you can see the pith. Pith is followed by the primary xylem, and you can see the presence of resin canals also in between. You can see the medullary rays. After that primary xylem, the broader tracheid cells, or else the broader tracheids of xylem will be forming a springwood. It is of a springwood, and springwood is followed by the autumn wood. After that autumn wood, you can see this is of cambium. This region is of a cambium. Cambium is followed by the secondary phloem. This is of a secondary phloem. Then this region is of cortex. So cortex is interrupted by the presence of resin canals again, and cortex is followed by corcambium. So here it is of corcambium and this is of cork. So here is of another slide, that is of Pinus 2 year old stem. So let us take a look. At the center you can see the pith. Pith is followed by primary xylem, and then in middle you can see the presence of medullary rays and resin canals also. Medullary rays, these are the medullary rays, and then the resin canals, these are the resin canals, and you can see the springwood. So the broader cells are called as a springwood. You can see those are of lightish in color, and that is followed by the autumn wood, which are tightly packed. The cells are tightly packed or thickly arranged. After that, so one springwood, one autumn wood, then other springwood. So here you can see, now this is of a springwood again, then this is of autumn wood. So you can see the two sets of springwood, autumn wood. So that makes it of two annual rings, which means that this stem is of 2 years old, and that is followed by the cambium. Here this is of a cambium, this is of cambium, and then this is of a secondary phloem. Here you can see some crushed cells, no, those are of primary phloem, and then that is followed by the cortex. So this region is of a cortex, These here you can see the resin canals, and this is of cork cambium and then the cork. So this is about the slight study of a 2 years old Pinus stem. So for more videos and information, please subscribe this channel. Thank you.